Hello there, welcome to Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor with you. Here are all the updates on the coronavirus pandemic from across the world. Around the world now, more than 2.08 million people have tested positive for coronavirus, and there have been more than 1,34,000 people who are dead because of COVID-19. The United States is the worst affected country. Yesterday, it reported 2,600 people dying in one single day, and that has taken the US's total death toll to more than 30,000. And in that country, there are more than 640,000 cases of coronavirus. However, US President Donald Trump has said that despite the spike in the number of cases and deaths, the US has passed the peak of the infection. And he has also reiterated that there will be some states that will be reopening this week. He said he will hold consultations with the governors of different states and will take a decision by Thursday. Meanwhile, US President Donald Trump has also again highlighted the possibility of a coronavirus originating in a Chinese lab rather than Wuhan market. So he said that the US intelligence is actually looking into the possibility that the coronavirus originated in a Chinese lab rather than a market. Meanwhile, Washington State's governor has signed an order for the immediate release of prisoners due to COVID-19 concerns. So all the inmates who are serving time for non-violent and non-sexual offenses who were scheduled to be set free by 29th of June this year are eligible for this early release. And now news from Europe. In Europe, restrictions are being reviewed. So several European nations are now reopening after their lockdowns. And after Spain and Italy yesterday, Germany also announced its plans to partially reopen schools and some businesses by Monday. And very interesting news from UK, where a 99-year-old British Army veteran has been able to raise more than $14 million in the fight against coronavirus. How? Only by walking in his garden. Well, yes, he aimed to complete 100 laps in his garden by his 100th birthday, aided by just a walking frame. And he walks 10 laps each day in his garden in Yorkshire to raise the money. And he has been able to raise more than $14 million. And while many European countries are reopening, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has warned that the lockdown in his country is going to continue for weeks. And this, he says, that even as his country has been spared the worst of COVID-19. The country has about 30,000 cases and 1,000 deaths have also been reported in Canada. But Trudeau is very categorical in stating that the lockdown is going to continue for weeks. And in more news from Canada, the medical charity Medicines Sans Frontiers has launched its first ever project in Canada to help the homeless people who have been infected with novel coronavirus. Now, this is something very new because this medical charity MSF usually works in developing countries or in war zones. And now news from China. China saw first local transmissions in weeks. So 12 cases of locally transmitted coronavirus infections were reported in China. Remember, China is already very concerned about the imported cases because it fears a second wave of infections in the country. Yesterday, it reported 34 imported cases. But there is now also concern in China about the locally transmitted cases as well. Meanwhile, in more news from China, a second city from China has banned eating of dogs and cats in view of the global coronavirus pandemic. So the city of Zhuhai followed the example of the Shenzhen city near Hong Kong in banning the eating of dogs and cats. And now news from South Korea. As you know that South Korea yesterday held its national election, and in that election, Moon Jae-in's ruling party has emerged victorious and it has got a majority. Meanwhile, yesterday, South Korea also only reported 22 new cases of coronavirus, and this was the fourth consecutive day that less than 30 infections were reported. Remember, South Korea has more than 10,000 cases of coronavirus, but more than 7,400 people have recovered, and there have been only 229 deaths in that country. And in more international news, the G20 group of top economies have suspended the debt payments owed to them by 77 of the world's poorest countries. And the International Monetary Fund has now said that the impact of coronavirus on Asia will be severe across the board and it will be unprecedented. The IMF said that it is highly uncertain as to how this year, that is 2020, will progress, but it said there are hopes of a rebound in 2021. So those were all the updates related to coronavirus pandemic from across the world. Thanks for watching.